I can remember the first few months, there were instances that she spent more than what was given. So by the second week, she would come to me, "Oh daddy, I'm bankrupt, you know, I've used up all my money." So I thought these are actually very good life lessons. Hi everyone, my name is Chee Kian. I'm a senior advisor with Providend. This year I'm age 50. I have two children. My girl is 21. My boy is 15. Since young, I find that to discipline them, I need to make sure that the discipline must fit the crime. Let's say when they don't keep their toys, I will make sure that they may not be able to play them later because they need to take responsibility about keeping it. Or if they fight, I find a good way to discipline them not to fight. I make sure that they hug each other until they say sorry or say I love you. So they remember that if they fight, then they have to go through this uncomfortable experience so that they will not do it again. So when they are much older, the discipline has to be appropriate to their age. I will need to talk to them. It's more one-to-one. Need them to buy in why I believe that certain things need to still be done, because the values that I have and the standard that I require, I need them to really understand why I'm coming from that point of view. So it's not just about quality and quantity, it's also about the outcome, meaning that will I be able to get them to trust me, right? So when they have an issue, I should be the person they come over to talk to me, to discuss. To really develop the trust, you need to have the relationship. So I intentionally spend time with them nowadays. My son, like most boys, he's really into gaming. I will bring him to time zone. We can spend like an hour or two and thereafter go and grab a meal. He really likes Japanese food, say like ramen or sushi. And over the meal, yeah, we can talk about his school, talk about certain things that he liked or some problem that he faced. And for my daughter, she's into dance and fitness as well. What I'll do is maybe we'll go to have a walk at the beach or cycle or even just to go out for a meal. Currently now she's in the second year of university. I remember after first year in NUS, she decided to change faculty. So that was a big decision. So I think we have many talks over what her interest in and what is her passion about and something long term. Even though she did well in science, her original faculty, but I think in the longer term, she don't see herself doing that kind of work. So we try to get some of my friends to share some of the different kind of career choices, something that she's keen into. So now she's doing arts in mass media and communication. I've with Providend since 2007. So that's been about 14 years. So some of the earlier clients that I engaged, I have also grown together with them in a sense. Let's say they came in, their kid was 7 years old. So now 14 years later, they are 21. So similar to like my daughter. We are a bit like family. For example, you meet your extended family during Chinese New Year once a year. We talk about their financial health, we talk about their accumulation goals, their challenges. So fast forward, say 14 years into the relationship, a lot of them are near their retirement. They have accumulated their net worth according to the plan. And this whole journey just makes this career so much more rewarding because you can see a plan and the step-by-step process. I'm really happy for them that they are able to meet their goals. Really, if they want to, they can really retire. Now we are more into like a second generation, helping their children to look into this. So I have many experience where the parents say, "Oh, I like to open up an investment account for them." You know, they have all this ang pao money along the way that are just sitting in the bank, right? So they need to make their money work harder. So I think one of the most important thing for children to learn initially is really about income and expense. When we can give them more responsibility to think about this by giving them, say, a monthly allowance instead of just a daily or weekly, right? So then they can allocate. For example, my girl, when she started secondary school, so I start to give her a monthly allowance. I will credit into her bank account and then she's able to withdraw for her use. I can remember the first few months, there were instances that she spent more than what was given. So by the second week, she would come to me, "Oh daddy, I'm bankrupt, you know, I've used up all my money." So I thought these are actually very good life lessons. I think after that 2-3 months, I've never seen her having that issue again. I suppose it goes well into our adulthood as well. As we get earned an income, we know that the biggest lesson is to make sure that we are able to put some money aside and not overspend. I just shared a bit earlier about the role of a father with my kids. And I think one of the conclusions I have is that trust is important. As a measurement of whether you have been successful as a father, to me, is that they will share their concerns. They will come to you and seek your advice. Being a wealth advisor, my relationship with my clients, I also feel that there's this similarity where they have the trust, and when they want to make any major financial decision, they will think about getting an opinion from me. So we have a discussion. We can be their CFO, for example, right? To really look at the numbers, to make sure that the decision that they make is really covering all angles, see whether there's any blind spot with their rear view mirror, for example. So this kind of relationship that is built on trust, I think is really what makes this role as a wealth advisor very rewarding and satisfying.